So today I am going to tell you how to download the GNU radio, how to install it, and then how to basically perform the experiments. Okay. So in order to download the GNU radio, you could just Google search GNU radio companion, and once you get that, you would get a tab called a Windows install. Just click on it. Okay. Wait a little bit. Yeah, so here you could see the different binary installers are there. So the first one is Geoff Niebuhr's installer. You could get it, just right click and just open a new tab. You could install the download, you could select this one, download latest GR 3.8 installer, because this is a stable version, so you could download it. You could also install 3.9, but it could be having some issues because it is a beta version. Just click on download, and then the installation is similar to any other software installation. Okay. So now let me just tell you how to work with the GNU radio companion. So just type, just click the start button of your computer, and you could type GNU, and then the GNU radio companion will be found. You could just click on it. Okay. So in order to start your first experiment, you should go to file, then new, and then Qt GUI, GUI. So just click on it. So once you click on it, you would get two different things. One is a basically a variable where the sample rate is defined. You could just double click on it. Okay. You could just double click on it, and you could just specify the sample rate here. So mostly you should choose a sample rate which is at least 2 or 3 times the Nyquist rate of the maximum frequency that you have chosen. Let's say I am using 100 hertz as the maximum frequency of the signal in my project, basically that I will be doing. So this could be your 1000 or 10,000, something like that. So 1000 will also work. You could just apply, and then you should click on OK. So sometimes after you have done this, you should save it. Go to save, and you could save it as, let's say, demo4.grc. So once you have done that, just click on the save button and it will be saved. Once it is saved, just click on these options and make sure that this ID has changed to demo4. Okay. So once you have done, next let us do the experiment on your amplitude shift keying. Okay. So in order to implement the amplitude shift keying, all the things have been actually mentioned in the manual itself. Still I am showing you that. So just in the manual you could see, yeah, the experiment 6 manual, you could see that the experiment is basically generation and detection of amplitude shift keying using your GNU radio. Okay. So all the steps have been mentioned here. Exactly what I will be telling you, exactly those steps will be actually mentioned here. Okay. So in the GNU radio, just click on control and then F. Okay. And then you could just type the signal source. So once you click on signal source, you would get the signal sources here. Okay. So basically for ASK generation, we would need 2 different signal sources. The first one will be generating the baseband signal. Just double click on the block. Okay. Just double click on the block, make the complex, the output type to float. Okay. And then the frequency to be approximately 5 hertz could be better. And it will be a square wave because this is representing our baseband signal. Then click on apply and then okay. Similarly, for the second signal source, click, double click on it. You would get the properties. So they are change to float, okay, in the cosine wave, and you could change the frequency to 100 hertz, and then click on apply and then okay. Okay. So once you have done that, you could bring in a multiply block. So just type multiply and you would get a multiply block. So place it here and then double click on it and change the IO type to float, because we will be working with the float data types here. The next thing that you need to do is you have to bring a time sink, basically. So time sync, for you could just type time and you will get this Qt GUI time sync. So just bring it, then change the output type to float, the type to float, and you, if you want, you could turn on the grid. If you want, you could turn on auto scale. Okay, and besides that, the number of inputs that we will be taking here is 3, because we will be showing 3 different signals here. Okay, then you could go to the config tab and just you could click on the control panel and make it yes, so that this control panel is visible. Okay, then line 1, the first signal that we will be showing here is the baseband signal. So you could change the label to baseband. Okay, similarly, the second thing signal that we will be showing is the carrier, so you could change it to the carrier. Okay, similarly, the third signal that we will be showing is the ASK modulated signal. So you could change it accordingly. Okay, once you have done this, just click on apply and then OK. The next thing is we have to connect the different blocks. So click on that out on the signal source and then connect it to the multiply block. Do the same for the second one also, and then click on the multiply block and just connect the output to the input of the time sync. Okay, then we will also connect the signals, so respective signal sources, to the this time sync. So I have connected them accordingly, as you could see. Okay, so once you have done this, you would see that this execute flow graph icon is now visible, and we could just click on it to execute it. Okay, so let me click it. So you could see the signals here. So all the signals are in the same axis. If I change the trigger to auto, these things will be clearly visible. Then if let's say I want to visualize only one of these signals, okay, so I could just click on carrier and ASK modulated signal, the rest of the things will be removed automatically. So let's say I want to also display the ASK modulated signal along with the baseband signal. Okay, so let me just decrease the X max a little bit. Okay, and then you click on this ASK modulated signal again, you could see that the signal which is being transmitted with respect to the bitstream is visible along with the bitstream itself. Okay, similarly, if you want to just see the carrier, you could click on it, on the carrier, and you could visualize it. So in this way, you could visualize the different signals. Okay, so let me close it. Let me also show you how to use multiple time syncs along with the this particular block diagram. So I am bringing multiple time syncs here. The reason is that I want to display these graphs in different windows. Okay, so just click on float and then go to config and make the control panel to yes and okay. We also need to config change the signal type, change the label to carrier. Okay, so here we will be displaying the carrier and the first graph that you have seen here. So we will be reducing the number of inputs to 1 again, and then I'll go to config and the control panel is yes. So here I will be only displaying the baseband signal. Okay, and the last one, let me also change it to float, and then I can go to config and control panel to yes, and here I will be showing you the ASK modulated signal. Okay, so just click on it. Okay, and then you could connect the different blocks accordingly. So I have already connected the baseband signal, I have already connected the modulated signal, let me connect the carrier also. Okay, so once you have done this, you could click on this execute flow graph icon again, and the things would be visible in different graphs, as you could see. Okay, so this is how you could visualize these things in different graph windows. Okay, in the earlier case, if you could recall, we were plotting everything on the same figure window. So that is very good. The previous case was really good if you wanted to compare the bit stream along with the modulated signal, but in this case it will be a much legible thing. Okay, because all the things are displayed in different graphs, and it will be easier for you to plot it. Okay, let me close it. Sometimes like students would ask you, like as we have given them some modified tasks, so student would be required to visualize the frequency sync also. So to do that, on the search bar you could type frequency sync. Okay, so once you click on type the frequency sync, you would get a Qt GUI frequency sync. So bring it on, double click on it, make it float. Okay, once you have done that, you could go to config and make it yes. Okay, so if you want to have a label, you could give it here, such as spectrum of the ASK signal. We could type it like this and then click on apply, and I'll just connect the ASK signal here. Okay, so once you have done that, you could just execute it again. So this time when you execute, you could see that the spectrum is clearly visible here. Okay, so if we increase the number of FFT a little bit, okay, you could see. Okay, and then if we increase the window to rectangular, you could see, you could clearly see the side lobes basically. If you want to, let's say, visualize a part of this spectrum, because this is from minus in something to plus something, so just click on it and you could just select the area you want to zoom in. Okay, so I'm just selecting this, and you could see things have been zoomed. The carrier frequency that we have taken is 100 hertz, so that's why the same is visible here. Okay, so this is how you could visualize the spectrum. The next is the demodulation. So in order to demodulate the signals, so we would need to regenerate the carrier. Actually there are two ways. One is you could recover the carrier from the signal itself, okay, which is a modified task for the students. The other is we will be having a signal source block and we will be generating exactly the same frequency. So let me bring in a signal source block, okay, and I'll set the frequency of this block to again 100 hertz, and the output type is float. Okay, and similarly I will also bring in a multiply block to multiply this carrier with the incoming signal. I'll also convert the IO type to float. Okay, and then let me bring a low pass filter also, which will be helpful in recovering the original signal. Okay, so low pass filter is there, just double click on it, and then keep the FIR type as float to float decimating. So decimation is 1, that means same number of input and same number of output. The cutoff frequency, let us keep it at 50 hertz or 25 hertz, something higher than the baseband frequency would work. Okay, so I have taken it like this, you could choose it yourself also. So transition width, you could keep it as 1, and then you just click on apply and then OK. Since we will have to visualize the signal also, let me bring in a time sync also. So there is a time sync here in which we will be showing the demodulated signal. So change the type to float, go to config and make it yes. And this is the demodulated signal. Okay, apply and click on OK. Let us now connect the different blocks. So here you are getting the baseband signal, from here you are getting the signal source, then multiply, from the multiply block we are applying it to the low pass filter, and from the low pass filter to the Qt GUI time sync. Okay, so once you have connected all this, do not forget to save it. Once you have saved it, you could just execute it. So you could see the bitstream is now visible. Okay, so you could compare this with the input bitstream also if you want. Okay, so all these things are possible using this particular software. You could bring in the trigger to auto. Okay, so in this way the signal can be recovered. So this is how you could perform the experiments using the GNU Radio Companion. Okay.